Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Let's Play Binding of Isaac, Wrath of the Lamb Edition. Again, I'm going to subject myself to the whim of the random button. We're going to play as Blue Baby. I will probably die in about 45 seconds, and then we will re-random another character. But for now, let's make the best of it. We'll shoot the poop, and then we'll shoot the moon, and then there's going to be rainbows, and everything's going to be all happy, and we're going to get the Platinum God achievement on this run alone. So, in Binding of Isaac news, sometime over the next 48 hours... Well, actually, that is a misnomer because this video will probably go up like 6 days after I record it. But in any case, sometime, probably several days ago, by the time you're watching this video, there will have been an update to The Binding of Isaac from Edmund McMillan himself that has added like 8 new achievements to the game and is going to rebalance things greatly. And I think it's hinted at in his blog post at edmundm.com. That it is going to make the game substantially more difficult again, which is going to be awesome because I've been kind of tearing ass through this game so far. So I'm looking forward to this rebalancing patch again. By the time you watch this, you will have probably been playing it for weeks. Inevitably, you will all have complaints about it that you will address in the comments. But alas, I'm still looking forward to it, so don't shit on my parade yet. This is a new item. What is this? Infestation. They grow inside. Alright, that's the same thing it says for Mulligan. That thing looked like a silkworm. Like, is it possible that this one is like a mulligan for silkworms that allows me to create my own silkworms? We'll see, anyway. At the very least, even if I fail, it's another item towards my way of getting to Platinum God, which is, of course, you know, the greatest I thought I was gonna get hit there. The greatest achievement known to man. Maybe it's when I get hit, I produce silkworms or something? That's my educated guess based on the look of the item and the item description when I picked it up. Who knows? We'll find out eventually, but for now I'm just gonna do my best not to get hit. Blue Baby has become a little green with that yellowing item. But it's all good. So yeah, and also 8 new achievements for the Binding of Isaac, which is crazy because, you know, I was looking the other day, and again, the timeline is gonna be all fucking distorted because there's such a lead time on these videos right now. I don't want a health upgrade. I want something better. That's like one spirit heart, man. Yeah, there's such a lead time on these videos that like right now it's like June 16th for me, and this video probably won't go up until like June 20th at the earliest. But in any case, I had gotten like almost every achievement in the game except for Platinum God. Oh, god damn it. $3 bill. I'm still not sure how I feel about you. Why can't I quit you? What was I going to say? What was I saying earlier just a second ago? Right, there's a lead time. So I was missing every achievement, or I had every achievement except for Platinum God and one other one, which for the record was not beating Shoal with Samson, despite all the angry Twitter messages I got. I believe it was actually like a secret achievement or something. It was like 2 remaining, but then I didn't know what it didn't show me what the second one was. The first one was Platinum God, the second one was something altogether different. So let's take out these guys. I think I've got freezing effects here. If I could actually hit them, that would be fantastic, and I'm really doing my best not to take any damage until, you know, a little bit late. Ooh, Mom's Pearl. I think that gives us random freezing effect, too. Trying to do my best not to take damage. Okay, so this is reverse mulligan, so now when we get hit, we produce flies. Which is not as good as the other version of the mulligan, because I don't intend on taking as much damage. Why am I wasting my time here? Why don't we just shoot him like this? Yeah. Here we go. 2 of diamonds. That's going to double our money. That's a card that we will obviously wait to use until we have a little bit more. I am aware, thank you very much, that the 2 of X cards also give you 2 if you have 0. So, for example, if I use this right now, it would give me 2 cents. Why would I waste it like that, though? I would much rather save it for a situation where it could really help me out. We got a bomb out of this. We got a triple shot. Want to take out Leaper Spider before anything else. Excellent. Now these hoppers might even go in one hit if I could actually hit them. Now 2, okay. So what do I want to... Oh, that's so shitty. What do I want to find on the rest of this floor? I want to find tons of money. I want to be able to go to the shop. In the shop, I want to buy Book of Revelations. I don't know, actually. I think it's still too early for any of that to happen. I want to find Tinted Rocks, I want to get a ton of Spirit Hearts, and I want to do a deal with Satan. So what I'm going to do is just explore the last remaining level here, I assume, or last remaining room. I assume it's not going to have anything in it, but if it does, then we will be sitting pretty. I could use a bomb to pick up 5 cents as well. In fact, if I could just get the 7 cents, then I could double my I guess like 8 cents. Like, then I could double my cash with the 2 of diamonds and go to the shop. So that's not outside the realm of possibility. There's 1 cent, so we need like... fuck. Can we make it happen? Well, here's what we're gonna do. Let's use a bomb to try to find the secret... Okay, first let's pick up these 5 cents. That's fine by me. We only have 2 bombs left. I would like to keep as many as possible. Because obviously bombs are pretty important when you're playing as Blue Baby. So you can get those tinted rocks and the spirit hearts contained therein. We get Book of Belial. You know, that's pretty damn good. I can live with that. Unfortunately, I just need like 3 more cents. But oh well, I guess I'll save my key. We'll fight whoever we're fighting here. Maybe we'll get Pageant Boy or something and then I can double that money and go to the shop. But for now, we got Duke of Flies. Almost feels like a waste to use Book of Belial on Duke of Flies, but suffice it to say, this is gonna make this fight fairly goddamn easy. Because all of his minions that he spawns are gonna die in 1 to 2 hits, and he himself probably died in about 15 hits, if that. We get at least 1 spirit heart, possibly 2 if he gives us a health upgrade, which is not what I want. That is a health upgrade. What does Satan want, though? Here, we can turn it around. Ouija board, 9 lives. No thank you. So down to the next floor it is, and we'll save our 2 of diamonds, use it a little bit later. No sweat off my nutsack. Doing fine on health, but the health pickups as Blue Baby are not that important. Much rather get some, like, passive damage upgrades. Almost... Blue Baby is probably the only character in the game where I don't like getting health upgrades. I mean, Maggie to a certain extent, and Isaac to a certain extent, because they start with decent health. But obviously, like, Samson, Judas, even Cain... like getting health upgrades on those guys, but, you know. Blue Baby, not so much. Because you can find spirit hearts anywhere, it just seems like a total waste. It's like getting a spirit heart only from a treasure room. We are almost up to 15 cents here, but we will... Oh, barely able to dodge those. We will go to the boss room first, because we're already here. I can use Book of Belial. You can see what kind of treasure we get. Maybe I'll have a chance to do a good deal with the devil. We're gonna get an item that is completely worthless for us. I'm just gonna pop that quickly, there we go. An item that is completely worthless for us, because obviously we can't even use the hearts that little Chubb would give us. That was close. Don't wanna waste a bomb to make this happen. And it seems like little Chubb is one of those bosses that I almost always fight when I play as Blue Baby. Which is, of course, incredibly frustrating. In fact, little Chad, that was a bad dodge. Little Chad is one of those bosses that I seem to fight only when I have absolutely no need for the item that he's giving me. Either I have a ton of health already, or I'm rolling in spirit hearts, which means little Chad is not gonna do any good for me. Shit. Okay, we're fine. Still good, wanna take out these red flies before I, you know, get too engrossed in the situation here. Oh god, almost dodged right into that. This has been a good little Chad fight though. You know, I've been paying attention to what's going on. Which is not always the case. And as a result, you know, I haven't been hit yet. Although that could come in the near future. That was close. Okay, little Chad, here it is. This is your final pass. Excellent. So that fight went well. We got red hearts. That's gonna be worthless for us. But that's alright. You know, you can't always get what you want. And then we do have Curse of the Blind. So I have no idea what direction I'm going into. But obviously we are gonna look for the treasure room. We're gonna look for the shop. Predominantly treasure room right now because I don't have quite enough money to make the shop worthwhile. But I will pop this 2 of diamonds at some point. And hopefully when I do pop it, it will give me enough money to make the shop worthwhile. Although I don't even want Book of Revelations anymore. Book of Belial is fine. I can live with that. But we need something more. That extra key is good. But yeah, we need like a... I don't know, some kind of extra damage up. I know, I realize Book of Belial is a damage up, ostensibly, but... just a little bit more, you know? Is that the Clay Aiken song, Something More? I can't remember. No, that's If I Was Invisible. Why am I quoting Clay Aiken? Come on, turret. Allow me to free myself from this terrible tangent that I've gotten myself on. There we go. Okay, so I can pick up that bomb, or that key for the price of a bomb. No need, we got the black bean, which is not great, but it means that, you know, when I get hit, I'm gonna be a powerhouse. I mean, considering I also have the mulligan. But, you know, I don't like those items that require you to get hurt in order to help you out. similar to the Razor. Or, I guess, you know, even the Whore of Babylon is kind of similar to that. Thanks for the half heart, little Chad. That's gonna be useful fucking never. Please just give me, like, one more cent so I can make the shop worthwhile. Maybe start getting something amazing to turn this around. You know, probably, if we're looking at standard shop upgrades, we would be looking at probably a compass, possibly a ladder, but occasionally you can get better items than that. This room, yeah, you know what, we'll pop Book of Belial just to speed things up a little bit against Wrath. Dude has a fair amount of HP. Let's continue making my moves here that make it possible for me. You gonna do something that make it possible for me to, you know, have an escape route if necessary. There you go, that's bad for you. Feel free to toss another bomb at me, you know, at your earliest convenience. There we go. I was hoping he would give me, I guess, like, explosive bombs, like, greater bomb power. Alas, no such luck, and I think that is the end of this floor. In which case, I will head down to the next floor. Still did not get a remaining cent there, but that's okay, we'll save it for a little bit later. Sometimes, you know, good things come to those who wait. Sometimes, he who hesitates masturbates. We'll see. We got Curse of Darkness again. Can't see shit, Captain. But we do have a Tinted Rock here, so let's blow that up. Fantastic. Might as well. Okay, Umbilical Cord is a terrible trinket. Well, maybe not terrible, but I really dislike it. And I'm gonna take a risk. I am gonna pop open this other chest here. Despite the fact that it's gonna cost me another key. Oh, that was terrible. It's gonna cost me another key. Yes, that's good. That's a... Yeah, flying, right. Okay. That was definitely worth the remaining key, even if I don't have the ability to go to the shop on this floor. That was terrible damage on my part. Did I get hit there? Maybe I didn't even get hit there. I do still have an Eternal Heart as well. Hopefully I'll be able to carry that down to the next floor, although I guess it doesn't really matter, it just functions as a Spirit Heart anyway. Book of Belial is ready. Still can't see shit. This is definitely worth popping this Book of Belial for. Let me take out one of these guys. This guy's taking four hits with Book of Belial on. I hate Greedheads. I hate you. I hate you, Greedheads. We need a lump of coal or something to speed our damage up here. Speed our damage up? Not sure about my diction there. That's fine. Now we've got enough money to make our Two of Diamonds much more viable. Feeling decent about our chances so far, but now I definitely need some keys. I mean, this is obviously going to open a lot of doors for me when it comes to picking up new items. So let's try to take out at least one of these greed heads. Fantastic. Now I have a place where I can stand and, you know, fire from. And we can just kind of do a counterclockwise rotation here. Should make it very easy to take out the remaining greed heads. If I could actually hit them. I feel like Rage would be an awesome pickup right now, too, but I'm not going to hold my breath for getting that one outside of the Deal with the Devil room. Really? There we go. Tons of hearts. If only Isaac had, like, multiplayer, and someone who was playing as, like, Judas right now could have access to those hearts. Alright, so make sure that we take out these guys. I did take a little bit of damage on this room. Oh, well. I can live with it. We do need a damage upgrade, I think. Base damage is fairly goddamn low right now. Fantastic. Another set of hearts I'll never be able to use. This room scares me enough that I think Book of Belial is worth using. I hate pretty much all of these nubs. Green ones, of course, being the worst defenders, I think. Hey, we found the secret room without having to look for it ourselves, which is always a bonus. Extra bombs. Three more cents. Again, I'm just waiting to use the Two of Diamonds until I am 100% gonna go to the shop. Or, you know, the alternative is I get another tarot card that I want to hold. Because right now, wouldn't feel bad popping this having 24 cents, but if we can get another 3 cents, that'll take us up to 30. Of course, that would be, you know, better than 24. Also, the same math that I use when I'm buying beer. Would you rather have a 30-pack or a 24-pack? Use your brain, you dungo. Go, live bomb, heart I can't use, treasure room. Crucifix is awesome, health and tears and damage up. So, there is the damage up that I asked for. Still doing fairly low damage, I'm guessing, because my tears are still clear. Or white, I suppose. Or bluish. Saliva color. Not really saliva, I guess they are tears, aren't they? But that's alright. So we're doing fine. A-okay. We'll just move onwards here. That is awesome. Fight the boss. What's up, boss man? Alright, we're gonna fight the Wretched, which is the first time I've ever fought this boss. Perhaps this will be one of those secrets that I've been missing in the game, and it will unlock an item that I've been missing. Which is awesome by me. It seems like a reskin of the Widow. Which is terrible. Maybe not even a reskin, just like an alternate version of the Widow. Oh, god damn it. Taking too much damage, but the Black Bean did good enough there. I lost a lot of health, but that's okay. What do we got from the Wretched here? Didn't even really get a chance to see what was going on. That is cool. I am into getting the Band-Aid there. And Sacred Hearts, that's more flying, and also that gives us Spectral Tears as well. Oh, I thought I was going to shoot the TNT there by accident. Okay, so we have damage now. We have enormous tears with random tear effects that may or may not be awesome. I feel like my tears are slower now. That might just be the $3 bill tier effects, though. Oh, right, my tears are homing, too. I forgot about that. So there we go, another cent. So we're up to, like, 50 cents now. Maybe I don't have Spectral Tears from Sacred Heart. What was that? I just have homing tears. That was my mistake. Oh, well. So we'll definitely visit the shop here. We might run into greed. If so, big deal, right? Let's pop this bad boy. Oh, I don't have any keys! How did that happen? Hopefully we get a key drop from here. Am I one-shotting these guys? Wow. How quickly things can change over the course of one floor. So I think we have a good chance of beating this game as Blue Baby now. It all rests on me not taking, like, a few rooms of terribly stupid damage, because obviously, like, I still don't have any way to replenish my health. But I've gotten enough of it so far that I might be able to coast for a while at least. Not having any keys is shitty. I should have held on to that Two of Diamonds, but alas, that's fine. The game's been kind of a dick with respect to keys lately, but we'll ignore it. Actually, we'll go to the shop, because the shop should give us keys, if only from this dude right here. I guess we might as well play this as well, because it'll give us Spirit Hearts occasionally. Okay, or not. What do you got for me? Good pills, I hope. Friends till the end, that's not bad. Was it worth a cent? Sort of. I just want keys, I don't need anything else. I appreciate the money, but the key really is just keys. If you could give me some of those bad boys. Cool, bombs also I'll deal with. Money, not so much. Is this game like... I think since 1.2 has come out, I've found it like nearly impossible to find keys. I really need that counterfeit penny. Or the flat penny upgrade. There we go, okay, just make sure we get it on this one. Fantastic, let's try that again for another 8 times. Wish I could play that blood bank. I mean, you know, I might as well just blow up the blood bank. Maybe we'll get a key out of that and it'll save us some trouble. More money. Okay, so we have only lost 5 cents total. More keys, here we go, this is it, this is the one. There we go, okay, now I'm gonna blow you up. And we'll leave the Ace of Spades. I'll survive on Mom's Pearl, I think it's a solid item. A solid trinket, I should say. And we'll make our way up here to where we'll probably fight Greed, which sucks. But we got 2 keys, not just one, so we'll have one. Yep. We'll have one to use on the next floor for whatever we want. Probably treasure room. Maybe shop. Probably treasure room. One more hit on Greed will be enough here. We get money, we get keys, okay. So we didn't really lose anything out of that. We can now just head down to the next floor with a clear conscience, knowing that we explored basically all we could explore here. Except, of course, for that second secret room, which is unlikely anyway. And we'll get an extra half spirit heart from this eternal heart, just for heading down, basically. Which is fine by me. Cool beans. Alright, and we can actually see where we're going now, which is a nice change of pace. Now, I hate zombies. I think I've made that clear enough. We did get 3 there, though, and we got a bomb back anyway. So that wasn't so bad. And there we go. Now keys are dropping like crazy. This always seems to happen. Oh, you need keys? Yeah, definitely. Just wait until the Depths Part 1 or the Depths Part 2. When keys are nearly worthless. Well, not nearly worthless yet, but very soon they will be. Now we'll see what this pill does. This pill will probably be bombs or key, just to fuck with me. So pill is... bad gas. Alright, no big deal. We found our shop, where we presumably will not fight Greed. Is my guess. My hope, at least. We have more red hearts, thanks a lot. We got the 9-volt, that's the battery, not the 9-volt, that's really good. Of course we'll buy that, and you know what, why not buy this key as well? That can open a golden chest for us, if nothing else. So that worked out fairly well, I would say. We got Sloth, Probably not even worth using the Book of Belial on, to be honest with you. Oh, that tooth! Homing teeth, pretty good. Tarot card is Wheel of Fortune. We'll probably blow that up at a later date. And I'm starting to feel really good about our chances now. We got Book of Belial combined with Battery. You know, we got a few treasure rooms left. We got a shop left that may or may not have a mini boss in it. We got a couple treasures left in general from bosses. I feel like we could easily get something to put us over the top as Blue Baby. Haha, no. So that was Ipecac. Ipecac is mutually exclusive with $3 Bill in my mind from now on. I would honestly rather have Ipecac than $3 Bill. The $3 Bill got here first, so I'm going to honor that. And I'm not going to take Ipecac this time, because my reflection plus Ipecac could seriously just ruin my life. Even though I have Sacred Heart, it's friends till the end, okay. Even though I have Sacred Tears or whatever I picked up, that gives me Homing Tears, I think my reflection would still ruin it. In any case, it's not worth the risk. That was a good chest. I opened it by accident, but it all worked out in the end. We got some delicious cash as a result. Fair amount, actually. We're still at 32 cents. Nothing else there. We got the boss. Yeah, why not? Pop this bad boy open too. Picked up a couple of cents as a result of that. Who we got here? We got Monstro 2. This is certainly Book of Belial worthy. Although he's an easy boss. I imagine we're going to be doing some pretty solid damage to him here. Now I need to get him to fire his laser beams. Okay, this is what I'm... Yeah, laser. Perfect laser opportunity. Laser. Laser me! Perfect. Now we got him in our trap. Oh, no we don't. He's outsmarted me. But he's already like 50% dead, so we're probably okay on that front. Laser beam, how about now? Yeah, laser beam, how about now? Another laser beam, maybe I can get down here. For a laser beam. And that was incredibly easy. We get a tiers upgrade. And with the amount of power that we have right now, it's probably in my best interest to just explore the rest of the floor anyway. So let's just scout around. We don't have too much more to look at. We could find some secret rooms, which would be good. Secret rooms have taken on kind of like a renewed importance, I think, in the Wrath of the Lamb update, because you can find Fetus in a Jar and Epic Fetus in them fairly frequently. Ah, we got like 1 cent there. That sucks. Should have tried to use that bomb to blow up the slot machine, but it's okay. It's okay. Not sweating it right now. There's another key, so we haven't lost any keys as a result of our golden chest opening so far, which has been good to us. Fairly good to us anyway, at least on the money front. Hopefully we don't run into greed on the next floor, because I would love to spend this money, you know, at a shop of some sorts, an emporium of items, pick up a 9-volt in conjunction with the battery, in conjunction with the Book of Belial, and just perpetually have max damage. You know, once you hit max damage, you stop damaging. That meme didn't really work out, did it? Sure, we'll just fly over here, we'll plant some bombs, because secret room has to be around here somewhere. We got some more keys, that's good. Wow, okay, maybe I don't know where the secret room is going to be. And as a result of our failure here, we will just head down to the depths part 2. Probably Necropolis, actually. I think we've done caves 1, caves 2, depths 1, Necropolis. It seems like we're due, even though that's not how probability works. But hey, I was right. So maybe I don't have to figure out how probability works. I can just use my intuition. I think that is probably the reasoning that leads to gambling addiction. But anyway, we'll work our way over here. I think I've expressed, you know, many opportunities in the past how much I hate rooms like this. But if I can just get weasel my way in here, get some keys. Book of Belial was used, but you know, I'd say that was definitely worthwhile. Taking very little damage over the course of this run so far. I've only been hit, like, by memory a few times. I guess I got hit most against that boss whose name I don't remember. Who was a total asshole. Ah, god damn it, okay, well. You know, there is our super greed. I think that was kind of inevitable. Now I'm taking a ton of damage. Hey, we got a quarter. That's useless. Hey, we got a spirit art as well, so that's not so bad. So I guess I probably mostly broke even on this floor. And I got a quarter as well, which maybe will come in handy at some point. And I'm just checking for the secret room there. On the bright side, now we can basically feel free to use these keys for whatever the hell we want. As Clips told me, keys open doors, so I will be looking out for doors and chests. A lot of Clips fans in the audience tonight? I'm gonna guess not, but, you know, there's always one or two. So Book of Belial's recharged again. I have a feeling we're gonna defeat Mom fairly easily here. Fool takes us to the shop. Hermit takes us to the shop. Fool takes us to the... Okay, first off, Book of Belial. Fool takes us to the spawn. Alright, that was easy. Again, like I said, tons of keys right after you don't need them anymore. So dodge those guys as best we can. There's our boss room. Don't want to go to that just yet, obviously. I would be remiss if I missed the last treasure room here. The extra bombs and keys are... Oh, God, what am I thinking? The extra bombs and keys are nice, though. And, you know, maybe we'll come across a library or something as well. I'm digging the Book of Belial so far, but, you know, Book of Revelations would not be bad either, considering I have the battery. Would take me probably longer to... That was bad. To kill enemies, but, you know, would also increase my own chances of success. It's a bad room. Don't need to mince words there. It's fine, we made it out. Really don't like going to the self-sacrifice rooms as Blue Baby, because, you know, that's health you probably are going to need later. It's definitely Belial-worthy as well. Do some dodging here. Man, Sacred Heart gives you some bitchin'-ass damage and homing tears. That is really awesome, actually. Not to mention, I think it allows you to fly as well. I think I mentioned that when I picked it up. So, you know, it's a pretty substantially baller item. Accidentally blew up that slot machine, but that's cool. I was gonna do that anyway. We got Rage, which is an item that I, you know, explicitly asked for by name a little while ago, so our damage is gonna be off the charts now. And what did I tell you? Library. Fantastic. So I think from a damage perspective, we are gonna be basically, you know, the worst nightmare for all of these enemies that we come across. Two more Spirit Hearts, that's fantastic. Library gives us items we don't want, okay. Now on our way back, we'll very quickly check for secret runes. Nothing there. Could be one here. I don't want to waste too many, because I would love to save some for the Mom's Heart boss fight. Okay, and we'll check here, and then we'll make our way to the boss. Okay, perfect. Inside we find 99 bombs. Okay. Now I will bomb my way basically through every possible opportunity here. I would say that paid out in the end. We could basically play this game as Dr. Fetus now, if we wanted to. Do I want to? Nah, I think my damage is strong enough that I don't really want to. Just checking for the secret room, the other secret room there. So we'll pop Book of Belial, of course. And I have a feeling Mom is gonna die fairly goddamn quickly here. Probably some of the strongest, like, non-brimstone Mom's Knife tears I've had in my entire life. And they're homing, which is fantastic. And they get stronger the more enemies we kill. Actually got hit there, which kinda surprised me. And this should be it for that fight. Wow, that was incredibly easy. So you get a range plus tears upgrade from Jesus Juice. And we are down to the next floor. Fortunately, no compass or map. But I can't complain too hard, you know, considering the quality of items that I've received so far. We got Child's Heart. No thank you. We'll pop in here. Sure, why not? I mean, we already had great tears, but Epic Fetus is always a welcomed upgrade. We can still fuck ourselves over pretty easily here. I'm just gonna try not to do that. Again, people keep telling me, aim with the mouse when you're using Epic Fetus, you dangus, but I don't want to. Because that would put my cursor on the screen. People always get freaked out by that. Hey, get your cursor off the screen. LOL, I thought that was my cursor. So instead, I'm gonna do things the old-fashioned way here and just try to split, you know, my right and left brain as I do this. I think we will probably be okay. The ability to fly means I can basically just sit in the corner if there's rocks where, like, enemies can't get to, and spam Epic Fetus and succeed greatly. I need to get more items, though. Like, I'm still... There we go. Da-da. I need more items to get this Platinum God achievement. We got Conquest. I don't like Conquest. I think he's a very difficult boss. And as such, I actually think he's a very good boss for this point in the game, because all the other bosses at this point in the game oftentimes seem too easy. Conquest, not so much. Conquest is a pain in the ass. But he's dead now. White Pony gives us the ability to fly and spam Heaven's Laser Beams, which we don't really need. I don't think Book of Belial does anything for us, but we might as well hold on to it because... You know, Pony wouldn't do anything for us either, really. I'm gonna leave that pill. I don't want to use that just in case it damages me. It's amazing how much this run changed over the past two floors. That is a very, this is a huge, like, late game alteration. Sounds like a prog album. Late game alteration. We know that's Friends to the End, okay. I've been taking a lot of damage on this floor, which frightens me a little bit. Oh, that's awesome. Feed me spirit hearts, please. I can wait. I got money. Alright, don't leave the house today. One step ahead of you. You're throwing your life away. One step ahead of you. Steven lives. Okay, cool. Maybe there's gonna be a new time folk anytime soon. Look to La Luna. It's actually like noon here right now. Cool, matchstick. More bomb drops. Definitely do not need that. Curved horn might be increased damage. That might be worth picking up, I guess, if it actually functions with fetus or epic fetus. You'll die alone. Not a big deal. Goat hoof, increased damage. How many times have I been in this exact situation? Just give me spirit hearts. That's all I desire. Okay, what is this tarot card? The lovers. Okay, that's two red hearts. That's garbage. What is it? Two of diamonds. Yes, double it. We'll be here forever. I don't even care which of these trinkets I have, honestly. There's our spirit heart. Okay, thank you. Spent 25 minutes here to make this happen. Come on, any second now. Pushpin, not interested. Mom's pearl is probably garbage as well, but... seriously, just give me something here. Work with me. What's this tarot card? I can't even get to it. There's so much shit I don't even want here. The lovers. Is that two lovers cards? Yes, the answer to that question is yes. Now I have the pushpin. I don't know what it does, I don't really care. Please just, if you're not gonna pay out, just explode sometime soon. I can't even get to the card that I want because all this shit in the way. Two of hearts. Okay, doubles are hearts. Doesn't even work with Blue Baby. Let's get that out of the way. In fact, let's get a lot of this shit out of the way. Lover's card. Pop it. Lover's card. Pop it. Okay. If only I had the D20 right now. It would be beautiful, beautiful day for me. We've cleared away the front of the slot machine or the fortune teller, which should allow me to actually be more efficient in my wasting of money. Amazingly, you know, we've summoned. That takes us to the item room, so it might take us to the secret room now. Or it might just function as like a telepills. Amazingly, we've actually gained about 30 cents so far from doing this, as well as a spirit heart. Yeah, why not? Let's pop that bad boy open, see what we got here. So there is a boss trap room. I'm actually going to make my way over to that. I would like to visit that. The arcade doesn't interest me as much. What about this? What do we got here? Empress. That's good. Actually, maybe it's not any good at all if I'm using Epic Fetus. Guy, kind of getting a little tired of this fortune teller, man. Cancer doubles our tears. I'm not even sure if that does anything. Oh, man. D20. D20 right now would be insane. So I am just going to... let's play it like one more time. There we go. Finally it explodes. When I say I'm going to play it one more time. I'm gonna go with the curved horn, because I don't really care about any of those trinkets. I'm gonna abandon that pill, because it scares me. Blow everything here up. Should be fairly easy. I don't expect the boss room is gonna be too much of a problem. We got money and bombs. Again, both pretty much useless to us right now. Extra money doesn't even interest me, so we'll just get the fuck out of there. Not interested. And we'll make our way down here. This should allow us to go to the secret room. Secret room may have nothing in it, may have something amazing. May have a mini-boss. I guess either way, I am not too perturbed. But let's check it out. Slot machine. Okay, well, we'll definitely explode that to the best of our ability. Then we'll come into the arcade and we'll blow all of this nonsense up. Cool, bombs, keys, and hearts, none of which I really need right now, but I mean, it's good to not be wanting for anything. It feels good, especially as Blue Baby. I've got decent health, I've got incredible damage, and good defense as well. Duke of Flies, color me scared. Alright, here's our mom's heart boss fight. You know, I've done this 1,000 times before, even with Epic Fetus. Let's pop the loud really quick, just in case it does do something. I don't think it does, but if it does... And if rage scales with fetus in it, or epic fetus here, we're gonna find ourselves doing a lot of damage very, very quickly. I mean, we're already doing a lot of damage, but we'll find ourselves doing more damage. Doesn't even feel fair, honestly. Mom's are just trying to like get away, but can't make it happen. Alright, continuously firing bombs, coming any second now. There it is. I can't believe Chubb's not dead yet. There we go. That was super easy. Up to the cathedral, where I assume we will succeed, but you know, we gotta find our way to the boss, which is not always the easiest thing in the world. It's best if I don't attack myself. Man, this room is kind of a pain in the ass, actually. Let's just hang out here, where I know I'm free from... Okay, those are both friends to the end. Decent items. But not worth the risk by any stretch of the imagination. Still doing fine on health. A little bit lower than I would have liked, I suppose. This room's kind of shitty. If we can just kill the greed... Okay, well that poison is going to do a lot of damage anyway. Okay, taking too much damage now. Gotta wise up. That was close. Going fine now. Okay, we did reach a dead end, which is shitty. Because I would like to be at the boss as soon as possible, because I still find Isaac difficult. Yeah, let's do exactly the same room again, bro. This should be a lot of fun. The room that potentially has contributed to the ruination of an otherwise great run. Okay, we dodged fine there. We're still alive here. There's been some good dodging going on in here. I normally don't like to toot my own horn this much, but... we're doing alright for ourselves. I think it's fair to say that if we had the relic or the Book of Revelations, this run would have been over a long time ago. With our current items, I mean, maybe not a long time ago, but it would have been guaranteed a long time ago. Two of diamonds, double our cash, sure. Try this out. I got hit by Gish, which is basically unforgivable at this point in the game. Starting to feel like I have zero chance now. Guess we'll see what we got going on. This chest, more bombs, could use some more spirit hearts, but by and large, I've been fairly lucky with respect to spirit hearts so far, so I'm not going to complain too much. Yep, we'll take the bad gas pill, we'll pop Book of Belial, and then we'll just start dropping nuclear bombs on this dude. I anticipate that I will lose fairly quickly here. I can only take two more hits. I can only take one more hit. We're doing decent damage. If only... oh, just make sure you got pro dodges. If only I'd aimed with the mouse! What are my flies doing? Just don't get hit. It's almost worth it to seriously take your time and, like, focus on the angel fetuses. One more, one more, one more. Two more. No! He was dead! Oh, well, that was a good run. I picked up a new item, we made progress, so as always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.